lot has happened since we introduced Business Data Cloud earlier this year. And today, we are really excited to take a step further and show you the richness of the intelligent applications available, as well as some of the new AI innovations. So with SAP Business Data Cloud, finding an intelligent application to answer my business question is as simple as asking Joule. So let's see it in action. So say I'm a CFO, and I want to know a little bit about what's happening with my cash flow. So I can simply ask Joule how my cash flow is trending over the past few periods. So after this, we can see that Joule has directed me to a link for my cloud ERP intelligence, giving me an immediate view of my working capital. So here I can review my key liquidity and cash flow metrics. But as a CFO, I may also want to have some information about what's happening with my sustainability. So let's ask a question about what's happening with our sustainability targets. Again, I ask Joule, and Joule returns for me our sustainability figures, and we can jump straight in and see how we're doing against our emission targets. But there are also many other C-suite users who have questions, such as, for example, a chief procurement officer who maybe wants to stay on top of spend. So in this case, I'm going to ask a more specific question about the linkages between my suppliers to leverage better volume deals and maximize discount opportunities. And with that, again, Joule brings me back a link, and I can jump deeper into my spend intelligence. Last but no means least, we're going to take a look at a chief HR officer who wants to understand more about how their talent flow and employee engagement is going. So let's ask a question here again. We're going to ask the talent flow in the organization, how many have hired, how many are leaving, and how many are being promoted. And we are linked to the people intelligence application. So let's dive a little bit deeper to see what's happening here. So first of all, here we can see our people intelligence application. So we can see we have many different insights that are available out of the box, and we can also see a comprehensive list of all the HR data products available within the package. So I'm going to go ahead and install that. So now we have it installed. So if we zoom out, what we can see here is our workforce composition insights. There are many other packages here as well, such as compensation insights, skill insights, with many, many more to follow. So jumping straight in, we see on our overview page a bird's eye view of the talent flow across our organization. But again, we can go deeper, and we can see those metrics by role, location, and many, many more. Within here, we have many, many different dashboards that we can check. First, we have a comparison tool where we can look at metrics such as headcount. We can go deeper on our role composition and see by job area, job family. We can also see how our organization, our talent is over our geographical location. And also we can start to see at our talent flow. So this, with the talent flow, we can see those that have recently left the company, those who have joined the company, and our overall attrition trends. But all of these analytics are rich in business context and ready for action. And they are insights I can trust because they are fueled by my HR data products. And now as I look across my organization, I see the overall attrition is slightly higher than we would have expected, and we should investigate that further. So to investigate that further, I'm going to bring in my data scientist to help me understand attrition trends and cause what's behind them. So here we're going to see a video of our data scientist who's working in Business Data Cloud. And the first thing we'll see is our data scientist opens SAP Databricks directly in Business Data Cloud. And here we can see how it natively connects to the data products within Business Data Cloud. We can see line by line the different information that's available to us, and also we can take the next step to prepare our data set for our attrition forecast modeling. And again, we do all of this right here in SAP Databricks in SAP Business Data Cloud. Here we can see our data scientist uses a Python notebook to create a confident and intuitive attrition forecast to help us navigate the road ahead. So now that we have our attrition forecast, we can go back to our dashboard. So we want to understand what's actually driving this rise in attrition, so we're going to do some simulations. So we open up our simulation tool, and we're going to create a new scenario. And the first thing we can see is all the different drivers we have available to us. Some things like compensation ratio, we have also development information, and also employee satisfaction scores, to name but a few. So we can get our settings going, and then we can run our scenario. Using the powerful AI simulation capabilities available in SAP Business Data Cloud, we can analyze tens of thousands of different business simulations on these key drivers to see which ones have the most impact on the overall attrition rate. And here we can see the compensation ratio and skills development are both key contributors. But let's take a step further. I can further extend my analysis by bringing in additional data, such as financial data. And behind the scenes, we see the BDC knowledge graph allows me to see the relationships between my data, and I can leverage the rich semantics and context for training AI models. So looking at that a bit deeper, we can start to see how we can ask Joule some more nuanced questions about departments and get a breakdown of our total cost per center per location. So we open Joule, and we start to ask questions about how we can group employees by cost center. So it brings that data back to us. So again, we have our HR data coming together with our finance data. We want to go a little bit deeper and understand our employee expenses. So these could be salary or travel expenses recorded against those cost centers. And again, we're brought back that information. And finally, I can combine both and get a clear view of the total people cost by team. Okay. So now, armed with this specific information on how we can proactively improve our retention, we can open SAP success factors and take action. So here we have seen from a single solution, SAP Business Data Cloud enabled both business leaders and data experts to connect all their data across multiple systems and deliver the answers our chief HR officer needed.